What's love got to do with it? Everything. According to the Apostle Paul, 1 Corinthians 13, the love chapter, he tells us in verse 12, first we see through a glass dimly, but then face to face. I liken that to a person who walks by a glass and you see yourself in that glass, but if you keep looking, you see through yourself to those things on the other side. That's what this lesson is all about, is looking past the surface and seeing ourselves through those 8 love types. All right? So, as you know, in the sermon, I talked about cross-eyed love. And I set the stage for this with Jacob, who was in love with Rachel, the younger daughter of Laban. But yet, Laban, according to custom, could not promise him Rachel as the first to marry of his daughters. But instead, he tricked Jacob, the trickster, and he ended up marrying Leah. Leah is considered the cross-eyed sister, the fair-eyed one. In other words, she's looking at you, but you're not sure she's looking at you, okay? But Jacob had to marry Leah, thinking she was Rachel, and had to keep that marriage alive. And isn't this interesting? She being the one that maybe did not look the part was the only one that was able to produce children for him. But yet in every attempt to give him children, she felt it would make him love her. And in each case, it did not. So this is called cross-eyed love because I want us to take a look at our lives through the 8 love types and really see not the surface, but see through the surface and to the real truth about these relationships. So in this segment, let me give you a scripture to kind of encourage you. 1 Corinthians 13 and 11, where Paul says, when I was a child, I spoke like a child, I understood like a child, I thought like a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. The reason why I'm giving you this scripture is because I want you to understand that the way we think as children is not the same as adults. So as adults, we got to go back and look at the same trauma, the same experiences that we've all encountered, and instead look at them as an adult and not as a child. That's the only way we can heal the child in all of us. The word distortion, I define that word and I define it again for you. The word distortion is so critical to this scenario or to this series, because when you talk about cross-eyed, you're talking about vision that is distorted. And the word distortion is the act of twisting or altering something out of its true, natural, or original state. And I think we can all agree, relationships oftentimes get twisted, they get altered, they get manipulated, whether it be family relationships, friends, romance, you name it. And we have to begin to look at this distortion in our relationships and seek for clarity to get vision correction. All right. And so we keep in mind, we talked about some of the distorted relationships in scripture. Jacob and his 2 wives, quite a distortion. Moses and his wife Zipporah, whom his own family did not want to receive. They rejected. And we could go on and on. We could talk about Dinah, who was engaged in sexual encounter with a young man that was not in covenant. Their village was not in covenant. We could talk about how her brothers went in and lied and destroyed all the men in that community, causing their father's name to stink. In other words, giving their father a bad reputation. We could go on from there, but I think we get the point. And the point is that relationships, oftentimes, whether it be romantic, family, friend relationship, all of these relationships oftentimes has some level of distortion. So, in closing, as I get ready to give you your thought questions, let me just remind you that some of these relationships, for example, are a person who has to foster a relationship with an abandoning parent. Parent wasn't there as a child, but now they're in your life as an adult. Perhaps we have to also talk about relationship where family is challenging themselves to come before your marriage or your potential marriage. Maybe friend relationships that have changed because of other relationships. Unfortunately, but we must talk about this, rape, physical abuse, and how it impairs our view of love on all levels. So with all of that being said, here are your questions. Number one. In what ways has your view of love changed in any of or all of those eight areas, but I only want you to focus on at least one for your discussion. In what ways has your view of love changed as a result of past trauma or experiences? How has that altered your view of love? Number two, as you journey with God, in what area of love are you compelled now to believe God to grow you? What area do you believe that you should surrender for God to grow you in that area of love? Perhaps to correct some distortion, to give you some corrective lenses according to the scriptures and the Holy Spirit so that you can engage again in a healthier form of that relationship. And then the final thing is simply this. There are many things that have occurred in which we cannot go back and erase them. However, we can reinterpret them, assign them a new meaning as we are engaged in relationship with the Holy Spirit and with people. And so with that being said, I want you to identify one thing that you believe will change in your life as a result of this introspective look at ourselves through the lens of the Holy Spirit and God's Word. Let me just forewarn you that these fig groups are not therapy. They are opportunity for us to find commonality. And in saying that, I would just caution all of us to use wisdom and what is appropriate or inappropriate to share. Please use discretion. I think the goal is to find commonality that we all have something to work on. But those short few moments that we have to bond with one another is not an opportunity to lay on the couch and be diagnosed. All right? I love each and every one of you. If you find yourself struggling as a result of this series and you certainly need to consult professional help, please shoot me an email or reach out to the office so that I can connect you. God bless each and every one of you and enjoy your healthy dialogue this week. Fig, what's love got to do with it?